What's going on, guys? My name is Yankee, and welcome back to another Call of Duty video today. So in today's video, what I want to sit down and talk to you guys about is Call of Duty 2016. But before we even get to that, let's just talk about the gameplay that you guys are going to be watching here in the background. And this is actually going to be another nuclear that I dropped. Actually, I played my first public match in like a month and a half yesterday. My second game, I dropped a nuclear. So I hope you guys do enjoy this in the background. I normally do not get a lot of nuclears, so definitely do enjoy this gameplay. But anyway, let's sit down and talk about Call of Duty 2016. Now, I know what you guys are going to be saying. You're going to be like, oh my god, this game does not come out for another 10 months. Why are we sitting down and talking about a Call of Duty game that's not going to come out for 10 months? Why are we doing this, John? Well, you know what? This is the reason why. It's because this is the perfect time of year to start speculating what's going to be in the next game and talking about what you want in the next game as well. Because we're only really, if you think about it, we're only like 3 or 4 months away from them actually revealing, coming out the leaks and the reveals of this next Call of Duty game. So there's a lot of information to talk about in these next 3 months. So we're gonna sit down every once in a while and talk about what could possibly be in this next game. So let's start off with what we already know here about Call of Duty 2016. First things first, we already know this game is going to be produced by Infinity Ward. And the last Call of Duty game they made was Call of Duty Ghosts. And you guys all remember how that was. Not a lot of people really enjoyed it as much as it was some of the other Call of Duty games out there. But this is going to be their very first year on the 3-year cycle. You guys remember once Sledgehammer came into the game, they made Advanced Warfare. That started the 3-year cycle of Call of Duty games. And since then, a lot of these Call of Duty games definitely have been balanced with the guns. And just have been a really well-produced game, I would say. I really liked Advanced Warfare and Black Ops 3 so far. I'm absolutely loving it. So I really have some high hopes here for Infinity Ward this year. But what could possibly be this game? Could it possibly be a Call of Duty Ghosts 2? Could it possibly be Modern Warfare 4? Who knows? There's so many possibilities still out there. We just do not know yet. I know there's been some Reddit articles out there leaking some things saying that it's going to be a combination of Modern Warfare 4 and Ghosts possibly. Don't believe any of those things, guys. There's absolutely no reason that someone would come out and say stuff like that this early into the life cycle of the Call of Duty game. But anyway, let's just speculate. What do we want to see? Let's just talk about what we want to see in this next game. So personally for me, guys, my top two favorite Call of Duty games of all time are Modern Warfare 2 and Modern Warfare 3. My least favorite Call of Duty game, you could probably guess it, yes, it's Call of Duty Ghosts. So definitely, right off the bat, what game would I personally like to see the most is definitely going to be Modern Warfare 4, but I just don't know really how far in advance you can go with the story. If you guys really follow the campaign, campaigns definitely do have like a big part of what the next Call of Duty game is going to be, but there's really just not anywhere to go else with the Modern Warfare series. You guys all remember what happened at the end. I'm not going to spoil it, just in case you guys might not have played it yet. And I mean, maybe you could go back before everything happened. I don't really know what else you could possibly do with the Modern Warfare series. But in Call of Duty Ghosts, when that game came out, I really did actually enjoy that campaign. It ended with so much suspense of what could possibly happen next. I don't think that Infinity Ward is just going to leave that out there and just leave the whole entire storyline basically with no answer to how the story is going to end. So I really do think that the next game is going to actually be Call of Duty Ghosts 2, unless they just completely forget about the campaign and say, you know what, the game did not do well, we did not sell as many copies as we would like to, so we're going to scratch the whole entire idea. It could pop in possibly, but I do think that they're going to continue that Call of Duty Ghost storyline, because there has to be something else that happens in this game to find out what's going to happen with these main characters. So in my opinion, I do think it is going to be Call of Duty Ghosts 2, but in my heart, I definitely want to see another Modern Warfare game, because I absolutely love that Modern Warfare series, and I would love to see the series continue, but you never know. But one other thing that I do want to talk to you guys about, what about the movement system? You guys all remember, since Advanced Warfare, so many new things have been added to the game. We've had supply drops, we've had the movement system. The movement system is going to be a big part in this next game. Do you guys want to see boots on the ground, where it's just basically old school combat, where you're just running around, you don't have to jump up in the air, you don't have to dash anywhere? Or do you guys want to see something like it is in Black Ops 3, where it's not really as vertical as you maybe in Advanced Warfare, but it's still, you're still jumping up in the air, you're run walling, it's a little advanced. What do you guys want to see? Do you guys want to see something like a Black Ops 3, or want to go back to the old school? That's something I just don't know. I really do like that, the way that Black Ops added it into this game. I think Advanced Warfare definitely was too fast. You're jumping all over the place, you're dashing, you can get across the map in 2 seconds, but I think that Black Ops actually found a way to actually make that balance. But I just don't know what I would rather see. Do I want to see the boots on the ground again, or something like Black Ops 3? So you guys let me know in the comments down below what you guys would like to see in Call of Duty 2016. We have so much more to speculate, so more things to talk about. So let me know in the comments down below if there's anything else that you specifically want me to talk about in the next video. video talking about Call of Duty 2016. Now, I will make some more of these videos every once in a while, not all the time, but it's gonna be a lot of fun to find out what this next game is going to be, because there's so many question marks here from Infinity Ward. So if you guys did enjoy the video, make sure you guys drop a like, and if you're new to the channel, make sure you guys subscribe, and make sure you comment down below your thoughts here on Call of Duty 2016. I'll see you guys next time. Thank you all so much for watching. Have a good day, guys. Peace.